गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू द ऑनलाइन क्लास। आई होप ऑल हैव डन द डेफिनेशंस वॉट एवर आई हैव अपलोडेड। ओके, सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट लेटर राइटिंग। ओके, काइंड्स ऑफ लेटर दैट वी विल स्टडी, वॉट आर द पॉइंट्स दैट वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी। सो एज यू कैन सी आई हैव रिटन हियर लेटर राइटिंग, kinds of letters. Okay, so there are two kinds of letters we are going to study, formal letter, informal letter. Okay, we will study formal and informal letter. First of all, what is formal letter? Formal letter means official letters which we write to the government officers or principal or okay, so those letters are called formal letter. Okay, informal letter means the personal letter. Those letters we write to the our father, mother, sister, friends. Okay, these are called the informal letter. Clear? What are the points we are going to cover here? Okay, formal letter is different from informal letter. Okay, that we are going to study. What is, first of all I'll show you what is formal letter and then informal letters. As you can see, I have written here some points. Okay, let me read. So in formal letters, there are 8 points we will follow. First point is sender's address, first of all we write. Then date, receiver's address, one who receives the letter, salutation, subject, body of the letter, subscription and signature. Okay, these are the points we follow when we write the formal letter. Clear? And when we write the informal letter, we follow sender's address, date, salutation, body of the letter, subscription and signature. Okay, so in first semester you will write two letters you are going to study. One will be the formal letter and another will be the second letter will be the informal letter. Okay, so let's discuss about formal letter. So what we are going to study in formal letter, so here in application also comes in the formal letter. So I have written here one letter, and when we write the letter, it is very important we should follow the punctuation, where we should leave the line, okay, one line, two line, where we should leave, that we have to follow. Punctuation we have to follow, that is very important thing, we just keep in the mind when we write the letter. Okay, so here in your first semester portion, whatever the letter we are going to do, this one, write an application to the principal of your school requesting fee concession. This is the letter we are going to study. Okay, I have written in the copy, just see. Write an application to the principal of your school requesting fee concession. Clear? I have written here letter also, you can see, and one by one I will tell you which part is called what. Clear? So as point I have written here, informal letter, first of all we write sender's address, to whom we send the. Okay, sender's address means we are sending somebody, we are writing the letter. So here we will write the sender address, means our address we will write. Okay, as you can see, just I have written here everything. This part first, when we write the letter in formal letter I am talking about. So here first we write the sender's letter, means we write our letter, okay, to whom we are going to write the letters. So here we will write our address, then we will write the date. Okay, then we write the date. As you can see, after the address I have left here one line, no, that is why I have written in the copy. So in the same way you will also write in your copy where to leave one line and where to put comma and punctuation, everything you should keep in the mind, it is very important. Okay, so here sender's address, as you can see, every here last here I have put here comma. So house number 405, whatever your address you will write. So comma here everywhere, at last full stop. After the sender's address, I have left here one line. So when you write, you also leave one line. Okay. After the sender's address, we write date. After date, again we leave one line. Clear? After writing the date and leaving the one line, we write receiver's address. Who receives the letter? Okay. So here we will write the where we are writing. We are writing to the principal of your school, na? We are writing. So here we will write the principal address. The principal, comma, Little Fly School, comma, Rapti Nagar, phase 4, comma, Chargawa, comma, then Gorakhpur, full stop. Clear? After writing receiver's address, again we leave one line. Okay, so what is the salutation? This, whatever the we write, sir, respected sir, that is called the salutation. So here, this part is called the salutation. After writing sir, again we leave one line. Clear? Then in the formal letter, we write the subject also. Clear? So subject here we will write. What is the subject? Application for the fee concession. Okay? So after writing the subject, again we leave one line. Okay? After this, body of the letter means whatever the content we are going to write here, what is the matter we are going to write here, that is called the body of the letter. Okay, so here we will write the body of the letter. This is called the body of the letter, content of the letter. Okay, after this, yours faithfully I have written. As you can see, when I have finished the body of the letter, content of the letter, when I have finished the letter, I have left again one line, so we will follow this, we will leave the line. Then here, just see, yours faithfully. In formal letter we use faithfully or truly. Generally it is very suitable, we should use faithfully. So yours faithfully, this Y, it should be in the line. Okay, it will not cross the line. Okay, so yours faithfully, then comma, here we will not leave any line. Here you will write the full name, whatever your name. Okay, so this yours faithfully, it is called the subscription, and this name is called the signature. Clear? This is the pattern we follow in formal letter. Clear? I hope it is clear. We follow the sender's address, date, receiver's address, salutation, subject, body of the letter, subscription and signature. Clear? And come to the next one, informal letter. Informal letter means the personal letter that we write to our relatives or friends. Okay, that is called the informal letter. Here we follow only the sender's address, means our address will write, then date, salutation, body of the letter, subscription and signature. So in the first semester, one letter is there, that is the informal letter. I have that also I have written, just see here. Okay, so the question is, point is, write a letter to a friend who is very sick and being treated in a hospital. This is the matter we are going to write in a letter. See, so this is the letter. Write a letter to a friend who is very sick and being treated in a hospital. This is the second letter. This is informal letter. This letter is informal letter. Okay, now look at here. First, what I have written, sender's address, means our address we will write. The same pattern we will follow, comma and punctuation. After writing the address, we will leave one line. After leaving the line, we will write the date. On which date we are writing the letter, that date we will write. In exam, you will write the exam date. When exam date is there, that date you will write. Okay. So here, I have written here, date. This is the way we write the date. Only we follow this pattern when we write in the letter. Okay. So after month, as you can see, I have put here comma. It is very important. And after this full stop, everything you have to follow. Each and every line carries marks. So please we have to follow the punctuation, leaving the line, everything we will follow in when we write the letter. Clear? After this, dear Arjun, I have written here. Here your friend, you will friend name you will write. This is called the salutation. We are dear, and this part is called the salutation. Dear Arjun, I have written. You will write your friend name. Again, after this, body of the letter. Body of the letter means the content of the letter. Whatever the content is there, here I have written. After this, again last one. Yours affectionately. Here in the informal letters, we follow yours affectionately. We don't follow faithfully. Faithfully we write in formal letters, official letters, and in personal letter or informal letters we write affectionately. Clear? Here yours affectionately, comma is very important. We write the comma without leaving line. Here we will write the name. Our name we will write. Clear? So this part is called the subscription and the name is called the signature. I hope it is clear. One more thing I want to tell you. I will upload this letter as it is in the written way. I will upload, because where to leave the line and where to means punctuation and all, that is why I have just uploaded like that only, whatever I have written in the copy. So you will follow the same. That is why I have written in the copy, because after all you will write in your copy only. That is why I have written in the copy. In the same way you will write. Your copy is small, what till where it will come, it's okay. Then turn the page and follow the same thing. Okay. So I will upload this. Okay, both letters I will upload. And as I have written, wherever I have left the line, wherever I have put comma, wherever I have put the punctuation, as it is you will follow. Okay? You will not write from your side anything. Only your address and your friend name. That's it. Okay? Your address and your friend's name, you can change it. Rest of the things will be the same. Clear? I hope letter, kinds of letter, formal, informal letter, it is clear. Okay, so when you get this, please write down in your copy. Okay, so in the same way you will follow as I have written. Okay, just see. First you write the question from the black pen, then only blue pen you will use for the address and everything. Okay, just see here. Wherever I have left the line, wherever I have put punctuation, same thing you will follow. Clear? The next letter also I am showing again. This is the formal letter. Sorry, this is informal letter. Clear? In the same way you will write in your copy. Okay? So I hope it is clear how to write a letter. So in the first semester, there are two letters, one formal and informal. I have written the question also. I already told the question. Write an application to the principal of your school requesting fee concession. This is the first letter. Second letter, write a letter to a friend who is very sick and being treated in a hospital. Clear? There are two letters. These two letters we will prepare for the exam. Okay? These two letters only you will prepare for the exam. Okay, let's move to the before starting the next topic, I want to tell you one more thing, that I have uploaded one more essay, pollution. So please download it and complete it in your copy. Okay, so after that, noun number, singular, plural, I have uploaded already. Exercises already uploaded. Lesson 7, Lesson 8, all the definitions and exercises I have uploaded. Complete it in your book and copy. After writing the 8 lesson, gender lesson, that kinds of that masculine, feminine, common, neuter gender definitions with examples, you will write that these two essays you can write. After this, you can write the essay, these two letters, then essay. Okay. And one more thing, that in that video I wrote by mistake that singular in place of plural I wrote their singular, that will be the plural. Okay, sorry for that, I did not see. One more thing, now this much you complete it and prepare it also. Let's move to the another chapter. Okay, let's move to the next topic. Next chapter, chapter 9, the noun possessive case. Okay, so chapter 9, the noun possessive case. Clear? What is the mean of possessive? Possessive means, what is the mean of possessive? It's mean ownership. Okay, when something belongs to someone, that is called the ownership. Okay, that is called the ownership, when something belongs to somebody. Okay, for example, this pen belongs to me. Okay, this is my pen. Okay, we say na like this. So many examples are here when something belongs to somebody. Okay, that it also show the ownership. Okay, it also shows the ownership. Okay, so that we are going to study. Some of the examples I will write. Books of Amit are very interesting. So in the another way we can say, Amit's book are very interesting. So this is, we are going to study apostrophe sign with S. Okay, that we will study in the noun possessive case. So first of all, let me write some of the examples here. Okay, so look at here, I have written some of the examples. Okay, let's see the first example. Books of Amit are very interesting. Okay, so another how this sentence we can write in another way. Amit's book are very interesting. Meaning of the sentence, both sentences are same but written in the different way. Okay, so books of Amit are very interesting, it is giving the same meaning. Amit's books are very interesting, the same sense and meaning is coming from this sentence. Okay, but in the second one, what we have done, we have put here apostrophe sign with S. Okay, apostrophe sign with S, that is only called the possessive case. That like this book, these books belong to Amit, no? So we can write in this way also, Amit's book are very interesting. Okay, the next is, the coat of Mohan is very expensive. We are talking about the Mohan's coat, we generally we speak also. Okay, so Mohan's coat is very expensive. So here what I have put here, apostrophe sign with S. So next one, these garments belong to Sarita. So these are Sarita's garments. So by adding apostrophe S, sign with S, we make the possessive case. Okay, so this is the rule when we talk about if something belongs to somebody, so how we make the possessive case like that. So Amit's book, Mohan's coat, Sarita's garments. Okay, in this way we change it like that. An apostrophe is added to a noun to show the possession or ownership. Okay, like Vimla's sarees, Queen's gown, the girl's mother is a nurse, the boy's clothes were white. Many examples are given here. Okay, so here are many examples. On page number 38 it is given. Formation of possessive form of singular noun, what, how we do. So first of all, I hope this much you understood. How we make it, how we change it into the, in this way we make the possessive form. Okay, so this is the way we change it. Clear? Okay, so now we are going to study formation of possessive form of singular nouns. Okay, so look at here, I have written here some examples. So first one, we are talking about how we change, how we can change in the that possessive form of singular nouns. So here we are getting the singular nouns. So this is a rule, we add apostrophe sign with S. So when we get the singular noun, Here this is Vimla's sari. This is Vimla's sari. So here when we talk about the singulars, when we change that, we put only apostrophe sign with s in the singulars only. Okay, boys clothes. The boys clothes were white. So here singular is there, na boy. So here we follow the this one apostrophe sign with s. The boys clothes were white. Another also, the girl's mother is a nurse. Again we follow in the singular formation apostrophe sign with s. Clear? Now when we get the many hissing sound means when the last letter it comes s, hissing sound comes. Okay, so here what we do in such cases, we use only apostrophe sign. There we don't write apostrophe s. Let me write examples. Okay, so here we write like that. Okay, so this example I have written. Okay, just you can see here, when we get the last letter, when we don't get s, here you can see last letter we don't get s na, so there we put apostrophe sign also and s also, means apostrophe sign with s we follow. Okay, to make the possessive case or possessive noun. Clear? But when we get last letter s, hissing sound, when many hissing sound comes, so again we don't write apostrophe with s, we follow only this apostrophe sign. Okay, we don't write apostrophe with s again. So here as you can see, Jesus sake, hissing sound comes, s is already given. So we have to keep in the mind only this much, when the last letter is s, so there again double s we will not put like that. Okay, like this. Okay, this in this way we will not do. Okay, we follow only the sign, this sign only we will follow. Clear? Only we follow this sign, we will not add again s with apostrophe sign. Okay, so in such cases we use only apostrophe sign, we again don't put s. Okay, when last letter is not s, there only we put apostrophe sign with s in the formation of singular nouns. Clear? Move to the next formation of possessive form of plural nouns. So look at here, formation of possessive form of plural nouns. You can see here, now we will see the plural nouns, how do we change. See, there are many girls hostels in the city. As just now I told you, when we get the last letter s in the possessive form, when we make, so we put only the apostrophe sign. Okay, we put only the apostrophe sign. So here we are getting girls, no, so already s is added there, so we no need to again put apostrophe sign with s. Clear? We put only the apostrophe sign, it will show the possessive form. Okay, so the answer in this way we will write, there are many girls hostels in the city, means there are many girls hostels in the city. We are talking about the hostels, girls hostels. Okay, second one, these are children's book. You can see these are children's book. So children is plural noun, no? Children is plural noun, no? So when we change into the possessive case, we put apostrophe sign with s. Just we keep in the mind only when the last letter will be s, we put only sign. When we don't get the last letter, we make apostrophe also and we will write s also. Okay, in the second one, third one, he is a student of a reputed boys boarding school. Here again we are getting here boys. Okay, so we put only the apostrophe sign. Again, we don't write apostrophe also and sign s also. Okay. So when we get the last letter s, we put only apostrophe sign. When we don't get last letter s, we write apostrophe sign also and s also. Clear? So like children's book, men's club, women's committee, all these are the plural nouns that ends in s. So s, we follow this method. Without s, we write apostrophe sign with s. So here, earlier where that example I wrote that boy's clothes were white. No, I wrote that example just before that. What was the example? That boy's clothes. So again, I am writing that boy's clothes. Okay, that boy's clothes were white. Just see what is the difference between here. We are talking about the this is the plural boys and this is the singular. So how we change into the singular possessive case? We follow the apostrophe sign with s. If last letter s is not there, then here plurals we follow the apostrophe sign only. Okay, we don't write. Just we have to keep in the mind double s we don't write. Okay, that's it. Last letter will be s, we follow only the sign. If last letter we don't get s, we will write apostrophe also and sign also. Clear? One more thing we have to keep in the mind. The possessive case is mainly used with the names of the living things. Means living things. These all are the living things, na? Children, girls, boys, men, women. All these are the living being. We are talking about the living things. Okay? But when we talk about the non-living things, there what we use, like, let me write. Okay, look at here. So, with the non-living things only, we put S apostrophe S. Okay, with non-living things, what we write? Here, as you can see, the tire of the car. We are talking about the tire. Okay, so the car's tire, we don't write. Okay, this is wrong. We follow this one. Okay, the tire of the, we have to write completely with the preposition of. We use of. Okay, so the tire of the car, we use the preposition of for expressing the possession or possessive case. Okay, so we write the tire of the car. This one we will not follow. We will not follow this one for the non-living things. Okay, for the non-living things, we don't follow this method. Okay, we follow this method. We use preposition of to make the possessive case. The tire of the car. Clear? The next is the button of the coat. The button of the coat. Here the coat's button, this is not correct. This one we don't follow. We follow this method using preposition of. The tire of the car, the buttons of the coat. But with the living things, with the living things, we follow apostrophe sign with s. With the non-living things, we use preposition of to make the possessive case. Okay, I hope this chapter is clear. So the noun possessive case, I hope it is clear. Just we have to keep in the mind only this much. Okay, we make possessive case by adding s apostrophe sign with s. Okay, when last letter we get s, then there we use only sign. When we don't get last letter s, then we follow this one. Okay, I hope this is clear. Okay, now this in this chapter we are not going to do any definition. I will upload the exercise A, B, C on page number 40. Okay, this exercise I will upload. You can write it in your book. Clear? A, B, C and learner's drill also I will upload. Okay? So I hope this exercise, this chapter is clear, letter is clear. Okay? So please download your that essay, letters, as well as the exercises, definitions and complete it. Okay, and revise your lessons also. ओके वन मोर थिंग आई वॉन्ट टू टेल यू अ पार्ट ऑफ दीज 10 लेसन्स वी विल इन द फर्स्ट सेमेस्टर वी विल स्टडी टू लेटर्स ऑलरेडी आई टोल्ड यू टू एसेज यूटिलिटी ऑफ द ट्रीज एंड पॉल्यूशन पॉल्यूशन ऑलरेडी आई हैव अपलोडेड सो प्लीज डाउनलोड इट एंड कंप्लीट इट ओके नाउ टू लेटर्स टू एसेज एंड वन स्टोरी ऑल्सो इट इज देयर सो दैट स्टोरी यू विल सी देयर on page number 142 please open page number 142 story writing just look at here the topic of the story writing is a golden egg okay a golden egg I know you are aware of this story so here on page number 42 this story is written you are not going to write in the copy directly you will study from the book Here is the story on page number 142. It is given here on page number 142. Here as you can see I have put here sign here. So you will start from here. You will study. The topic is a golden egg. Here from once upon a time a farmer lived in a village. Page number 142. You will study from the book only. No need to write in the copy. Clear? This is the story. Just see here. Okay? Till here. It is very small story. So, this story you will prepare from the book only. No need to write in the copy. Clear? So, story name I am writing here. Okay? So, one story you are going to study from the book only on page number 42. Story writing A golden egg Clear? A golden egg This is the story Topic of the story A golden egg Page number 142 142 and 143 okay so it is given there clear so you will study from the book itself no need to write in the copy clear page number 142 it start from here once upon a time you can write here the heading also no problem a golden egg then story it is given here okay just see clear till Distressed and sorry. This is the story. So 1 to 10 chapter in the syllabus of first semester. 1 to 10 chapters. Clear? Now one more chapter is left. Personal pronoun. That I will discuss. I will start in the next video. And 2 essays, 2 letters, 1 story writing. I hope this much is clear. Okay. So keep studying. And please complete your work on time. Okay, thank you. Have a nice day. Good morning, students. Welcome back to the online class. So, now today we are going to start the new lesson. Lesson 10, chapter 10, personal pronouns. Okay? Personal pronoun. So, first of all, what is a pronoun? You already know. Pronoun is a word which is used in place of A noun. Okay, it is used in place of noun. It is used instead of noun. Different ways are there to express the pronouns. What is a pronoun? A pronoun is a word which is used in place of noun or instead of noun. That is pronoun. We already know. So let me write first of all. Let me write the definition with example. Okay. So, what is a pronoun? A pronoun is a word that is used in place of a noun. That is used in place of a noun. Okay? So, why we use pronoun? Why we use pronoun? We use pronoun to avoid the repetition of the noun. Okay? To avoid the repetition of the noun again and again when it comes. There we remove noun. Okay? And in place of the noun, we use pronoun. So here one big example I have written, you can see here. This is Mohan. Mohan is a famous writer. Mohan has written many books. Okay? So first of all, just see, we are talking about Mohan. Mohan is a noun. So once we establish noun, no need to repeat noun again and again. Okay, as you can see, this is Mohan. We are talking about Mohan. Again, we have used here, Mohan is a famous writer. Full stop. Again, Mohan has written many books. So, two, many times when noun comes, when noun we use, okay. So, in place of noun, to avoid the repetition of noun, we use pronoun. Okay. To avoid the repetition of the noun, we use pronoun. So, here, what will be the answer? First of all, we established noun. So, this is Mohan. In place of Mohan here, according the gender, according if it is male, we use he, female, she, that we will discuss after that. So, this is Mohan. He is a famous writer. Who is he? He, we are talking about Mohan. Again, here we use he has written many books. So, to avoid the repetition of noun, we use pronoun. Okay, and pronoun, what is pronoun? A pronoun is a word which is used in place of noun. So, in place of noun, Mohan is noun, no? So, in place of noun, what I have used here? He. He is pronoun. Okay? So, here we use he. So, let me write it like that. So, in place of pronoun, we use he. Okay? So, this he is called pronoun. So, I hope what is a pronoun, it is clear. Now, we are going to study personal pronoun. Okay, personal pronoun, it means we will study first person, second person and third person. So, let me write the heading first of all. So, let's start with the first person. Okay, what is first person? Person speaking. A person who is speaking. Okay, means I am speaking. I, first person. I am speaking to you. You, second person. We will discuss after that. And to whom we are talking about, that is the third person. Let's start with the first person first of all. So, all pronouns that are used for the person speaking. Okay, person speaking are known as pronouns of the first person. That is called the first person. Okay, so what is first person pronoun? Person who is speaking. Okay, who is speaking means I am speaking, I, first person. Here are the examples of first person I have written. I, me, mine, we, us and ours. That we will discuss in the after some time. That subjective, objective, possessive, that we will study after this. First of all, we should know what is first person. First person means a person who is speaking. Okay. Persons speaking are called first person of the pronoun. These are the first person. These are the first person. Okay. So, let's move to the second person. Let me write first. So, let's see the second person. Second person, all pronouns that are used for the person spoken to. Okay. Are called pronouns of the second person. Person means all pronouns that are used for the person spoken to are called pronouns of the second person. Okay, means to whom we are talking. Okay, means I am talking to you. You is the second person. Okay, second person. Here I have written the example also, you, yours. Both comes in the category of second person. This is called the second person of the pronoun. Okay, so what is the second person? All pronouns that are used for the person spoken to. Okay, person spoken to, that we have to keep in the mind. Person spoken to, that is called the second person of the pronoun. Okay, for example, you, I am, I first person, I am speaking first person, I am speaking, I am talking to you, you. So you is second person. Okay, so this is the example, you, yours, second person examples. Okay, move to the third person. So just see the third person. All pronouns that are used for the person spoken about. Okay, person spoken about. To whom we are talking about means I am talking to you, I first person, talking to you, you first person, but we are talking somebody else, na, that she is very good, okay, he is very good, they are going, okay, so he, she, they, we are talking somebody else, na, we are talking about the third person, okay, I first person, talking to you for second person, I am speaking, I first person, I am speaking to you, so spoken to you means that is the second person. When we talk about person spoken about, that is third person of the pronoun. So all pronouns that are used for the person spoken about are called pronouns of the third person. Examples: he, him, his, she, her, hers, they, them, and theirs. Okay, so these are the first person, second person, and third person of the pronouns. I hope this is clear. What is the first person? First person, person speaking first person. Okay, person who is speaking, that is the first person. Okay, and person spoken to, second person. Person spoken about, that is the third person. Okay, so here these are the examples I have written here. I hope first person, second person, and third person, this is clear. Okay, now you just see page number 44 open. Forms of personal pronoun, here one chart is given. Just see here, one chart is given, singular and plural. Okay, so you already know for the masculine gender what we use. We use he, for the feminine we use she, feminine also we use her, hers, that we already know. And in the chart it is given, just see on page number 44. The following are the different forms of personal pronouns. Just see on page number 44. See here. Okay, this chart, you just see here what it is written here. Persons, subjective case means subject. Okay, we use as a subject. Objective case, possessive case. Here possessive adjective and possessive pronoun, that we will study in detail in the particular chapter, is given for that. Okay, and just see here remarks. I we use for both. Use for both means may, masculine and feminine, both we use here, masculine and feminine. Okay, you use for both, clear. Now here plural you, masculine and feminine both we use. Third person, he, him, his, we use masculine gender. She, her, hers, we use in feminine. It we use for the neuter gender, you already know. They, them, their, theirs, we use all genders. Okay, this is given on page number 44. So, I hope personal pronoun is clear. In personal pronoun, we studied what is pronoun. And after that we study first person pronoun, first person of the pronoun, second person of the pronoun, and third person of the pronoun. And this chart is also given on page number 44. Okay, possessive adjective. About possessive case, it's mean the belonging or ownership. Already we studied in the previous chapter possessive case. So possessive or possession always shows the ownership or belonging. Okay, Okay, so what is possessive adjective and possessive pronoun? One separate chapter is given for that. We will study in detail. Okay, but just one thing I want to tell you. Possessive adjective, as you can see here, it is totally different with the possessive pronoun. My, mine. Mine always we use in pronoun. Just see. And after adjective, we will get the noun, my book. This is my book. Okay. This book is mine. So, with pronoun, we don't use noun. Are, as. Okay, let me write one example. Okay, look at here. I have written two example here. Of possessive adjective and possessive pronoun. Just see. Again, I am telling you, we will study in detail in the chapter, adjective chapter. Separate chapter is given for the possessive adjective and possessive pronoun. There we will study in detail. So, only just one example I am writing. This is my book. Here, my is possessive adjective. Okay, what is adjective? First of all, we should know adjective. Okay, it qualifies noun. Okay. So, here my is possessive adjective because after this book is noun, it is given. Now, this book is mine. So, this book is mine, this is the possessive pronoun. Okay, both sentences are giving the same meaning. But this my is called the possessive adjective and mine, this is the possessive pronoun. So, this one is the possessive adjective and this one is the possessive pronoun. Clear? In pronoun, in possessive pronoun, after the possessive pronoun, we will not get any noun there. But in the possessive adjective, definitely we will get noun. Okay, only this much in this chapter I am telling you. In detail, we will study in the next chapter or one chapter, separate chapter is given on that possessive case, possessive adjective and possessive pronoun. So, there we will study in detail. Okay, so here this is the chart, you can just read it, which one is singular, which one is plural, okay, which one is objective case, which one is subjective case, you can see, just see here, okay. So, I hope this exercise is clear, okay, this topic is clear, I hope, okay. So, here as you can see, he is my brother. Okay, just see. He is my brother. Here he works as a subject. He is subjective case. You already know after the verb, generally we get the object. So, objective case we will get after the verb. Okay, just see. I met him yesterday. Now, here him is, it is in objective case. Okay, it is in objective case. Case. So, just you can see, okay, see him, okay, so let me write one example, okay, look at here, objective and subjective we are going to discuss, so before the verb when we get that is the objective, that is the subjective and after the verb we get the object that is the objective case, so here he is subjective or objective? Yes, it is subjective. In the next one also, I is subject and him is object. Okay, so here where to use means subjective case, objective case. Okay, that in the chart it is already given which one is the subjective, which one is the objective. We should keep in the mind before the subject, before the verb, sorry. Before the verb we get the subject and after the verb we get the object. Okay, so here he subject, I subject, met is verb now, here this is verb and after the verb what we get? Object. Okay, so generally after the verb we get the object and this him is, now it is in objective case. And he is and I is, both are the subjective case. You can see here. आई एंड ही बोथ दे आर इन द विच कॉलम सब्जेक्टिव कॉलम ओके इन ऑब्जेक्टिव मी अस यू हिम हर इट देम दीज आर द ऑब्जेक्टिव केस ओके सो वी शुड नो दिस सिंगुलर प्लूरल फर्स्ट पर्सन सेकेंड पर्सन एंड थर्ड पर्सन नाउ इन दिस वी विल I will upload the exercises here and here only we will do the definition of pronoun. Only one definition you will get in the last chapter. Pronoun definition with example I will upload. Exercises also I will upload. What you are going to do, one exercise I am going to give you as a homework, page number 45C, learner's drill. Scene, page number 45, learner's drill. So write 5 sentences about yourself starting with I and 5 sentences for your mother starting with you. Also write 5 sentences for your family starting with they. So here in the myself column you will use the first person means I you will use. Okay, starting letter will be I. Okay, here For here your starting word will be you. Okay, you will write about your mother. Okay, now here family you will write, you will use the subject they. Okay, you will use the subject they. Here you will use the subject I. In the mother column you will use you. Family column you will use they. Clear? I hope you can do this exercise easily. Okay, for example here you can write I am a good boy or you can start like that I am Hari, I am Mohan. Okay, in the second mother's column you can write you are a good mother. Okay, anything you can write about your mother. Family you will start with they are good person, they are good in behavior, they are very supportive. Anything you can write as you what do you feel about your family, that you can write. Rest of the exercises and definitions I will upload easily. You can get on the school website. Okay, so our first semester portion is completed. Okay, so the first semester portion is 1 to 10 chapter, that is the sentence, the subject and predicate, phrases and clauses, negative sentences, interrogative sentences, noun, kinds of noun, noun number, the noun gender, the noun possessive case, personal pronoun. Okay, a part of this, two letters, two essays and one story. I hope it is clear. This is the first semester portion and please prepare this, okay, and complete your notes also. Okay, so when school reopens we just start correcting your notes and all. So please, those who are thinking we will complete afterwards or when school reopens then we complete, no, please complete your notes. I have already uploaded everything on the school website related with the chapters. Okay, so first complete your chapters definitions. Okay, at last you can just write the, after the gender you will do the letter, two letters I have uploaded, that you will do, and one essay, pollution, utility of the trees, earlier only I have uploaded, so please complete it. Okay, that's it for the first semester portion. You will study 1 to 10 lesson, two letters, two essay, one story. One story already it is given on page number, I have already written there, 142, 143 page number. The name of the topic is a golden egg. Okay, that is given in the book, that you are not going to write in the copy, directly you study, you learn from the book. Clear? Now let me tell you about the summer vacation. Now this is the last online class we are taking of the first semester. Okay, you can say that this is the last one. After this you will get the summer assignment. Okay, summer assignment also I will upload on the school website. You just see there and Summer assignment you will complete in your copy only. Whatever the copy you got, that English one copy, tech, that school copy, there only you will do the summer assignment. Okay? So in the summer assignment, I will give the topic, write a paragraph on the topic my hobby, and 100 words you have to write, 100 words. Okay? So just see in the summer assignment what you are going to do. First of all, two questions I have given. Write a paragraph, okay, on my hobby. Okay? Write a paragraph on my hobby. So it is very easy. You can write about your hobby. Okay? So write about your hobby, and please don't exceed the words. It should be 100 words, not more than that. Okay? 100 words should be there. Approximately 90 to 100 words. Okay? So don't increase the words. Okay? That 100 words already I have written. So write on my hobby. This is the topic. You just do in your copy. After completing your all the class work, I mean all the lesson 1 to 10, when you finish your work, when you finish your all work of the first semester, then you will write the summer assignment. Okay? So in your copy only you will write the paragraph my hobby. And the second question I will give, change the gender. Okay? Change the gender. So here I have not written the words. In the school website I will upload this. Write a paragraph on my hobby, 100 words. And next question will be change the gender. Okay? Next question will be change the gender. Words I will give there. It can be masculine also, feminine also. Means mixed words will be, mixed words will be there. Mixed nouns will be there. Okay? You have to change it like that. First you draw the line, like what meaning you are doing now. So first you draw the line like that. Clear? And for example, if you are getting the gender boy, so here you will, what will you write? Girl. If here you are getting woman, so there you will write man. Okay, in this way you will do the second question. First question you already know, you have to write one paragraph only of the topic my hobby. And in change the gender, I have not written here the words. I have just explained how you will do in your copy. So you will draw one line like that. First side, you will write all the questions. Whatever the words I will give, you will write the questions. It should be mixed. Okay? Okay, mixed words will be there. Okay? All the masculine, feminine, it will be mixed. Okay? And this side, you will write the answer. This side, you will write the question. Like what meaning you are doing now. So this side you will write the question, whatever the words I will give, and the another side you will write the, you will change the gender and write the answer. I hope summer assignment is clear. Any doubt? I think no doubt, doubts are there. You have to write. First you will complete all 1 to 10 chapters, all the definitions and all the copy work, whatever is given, letter, essays, everything you will complete it. And after completing this, you will do the summer assignment at last. Okay? So I will request you, complete your work, download your whatever I have uploaded related with the chapter and essay, letters, everything is there. Please download it and complete it. Okay? And after completing all the exercises, all the work in the copy, you will do the summer assignment. And don't forget to complete the book work also, okay? All the exercises you have to fill in the book only with the pencil. So complete those exercises also, and whatever the exercises I have given you homework, that also you complete it, okay? So I hope you will enjoy your summer vacation. So keep studying, enjoy your summer vacation, every day little bit complete it, okay? Not in one day you complete all, in every subject you will get the summer assignment. So complete your work and keep studying and be safe at home, okay? Thank you. Have a nice day and happy summer vacation.